priceless land. But promises can disappear just like writing in the sand. Treaty, yeah, treaty now. Treaty, yeah, treaty now.
Vincent Lingari was the son of Gurindji parents, who was born in 1919. He grew up to be an Aboriginal stockman under the employment of people of the so-called white inferior race. Both him and his parents were employed in the 3,500 square metre cattle station of Wave Hill. Vince unfortunately received no education whatsoever, and by the age of 12 he was working full-time at the cattle station. Upon starting the job, big old Vince had no money whatsoever going his way. He eventually became one of the head stockmen at the Wave Hill station, and this is what would lead into his leadership in the famous Wave Hill walk-off. On the 23rd of August in 1966, the Aboriginal, who were sick and tired of how they were being treated as the owners of the land, decided to walk off the job. At the time, it seemed like a small protest which would end in the workers eventually coming back. But instead, it turned into a media frenzy with coverage with multiple news outlets covering the story. On that day, over 200 workers and their families left the worksite and vowed not to return till action was taken. Vincent Lingari was the one who led these families and represented in front of the public and the media. When Vincent had the opportunity to speak in front of the parliament, he said this: "My name is Vincent Lingari, come from Daguragu, Waddy Creek Station. I have come here to tell the parliament about the land rights. I got stories from my old grandpa that the land belonged to me, Aboriginal man, before all the horses and cattle came onto that land. I've got that story in mind." This message was heard all around the nation and caused a lot of people to talk. People were supporting Vincent on his goal to get his land back for his people. Finally, in March 1973, the newly elected Whitlam government had agreed on the 3,500 metre piece of land to be returned to the Gurindji people for residential and cultural use. On the day of August 16th, Gough Whitlam met with Vincent Lingari and poured a handful of sand, signifying the transfer of the ownership of land.
Free, yeah. Free, yeah. Free, yeah.